We have a read together of what we're going to be doing today, having a look up at our learning intention. Can we all read it out as a class? We are learning to count a collection efficiently. I want you to have a think about, what does that mean? What do we mean that we're going to count a collection efficiently? My name's Lauren Marriott. I am a graduate teacher still, so still learning the ropes. I've been in 5-6 for the whole time I've been teaching and love it. So to tune them in and to get them interested and wanting to learn in maths, we played the pick the number game. And during that, we focused on, I suppose, place value and the vocabulary of between. I'm going to introduce another word today. And when we're playing our game today, we're going to be working on between. So if I was to give you an example and I had a number, I would be saying something like, is my number between 100 and 150?
I
then went on to my introduction, which was modelling and doing a fishbowl of what the game looked like, the rules involved, doing a lot of questioning to try and get the students to figure out the aim of the game and to get the students to really look at the strategies that were involved rather than me telling them. Cody, do you want to have a share about what you've noticed about our train?
It has 10 little squares in each carriage.
It's got 10 squares in each carriage. I like that. That's a good observation. Ryan?
It goes up to 100.
How do you know it goes up to 100?
Because there's 10 in each of them. So, and then there's 10 boxes in 10 carriages.
There's 10 in each. And there's 10 carriages. So what we're going to do, we're going to play a game. And it's called Race to 100. I then got them back onto the tables in a pair to actually play the game.
What do you need?
I did make cue cards as well because I really wanted the students to focus on specific things.
There are 7 people on the train.
Good boy. Something full carriages. Do you have a full carriage? So how many full carriages?
None.
0 full carriages of the tens. Which equals? 0. And?
7 ones.
7 of the ones. I need. So I always try to ensure that I'm taking some sort of anecdotal notes. The ones that I was using today had down the side the different success criterias that I was hoping for the students to achieve. And next to it, it just had a beginning, a consolidating, and an established. And then down the bottom, it had a comments box. The other one I do is just actually writing rather than just a tick box. I like to write proper notes down so that I can refer back to it, any misconceptions, any misunderstandings, so then I can critically reflect on that myself as a teacher and make improvements from that. I can then go to my PLC meeting with all of my evidence, my proof and my data to say that they are doing this, this, this and this, and my evidence is there for the entire team to look at, and they will then say, yep, I agree, they need to move up. As I was going around to some of the students, I did notice quite a few misconceptions with what they were doing, how they were saying it, and even the strategies that they were using. So I really tried to hone in on my questioning and getting the students to figure out different ways that they could be tackling the problem, but without me telling them. I need something more to make 100. How are we going to figure that out?
41. I rolled a 10.
71.
How did you get that so quickly?
I counted these and then I added this one.
Why did you count these?
Because they're all equal to 10.
They're all equal to 10. So how many did you know were in these then?
10.
Yep, so 10,
20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, and I added
them on it. Wowee! So have you been successful in our success criteria?
Yep.
What strategy did you use?
I used counting by tens.
You did use counting by tens, so you could build to 10 and bridge. And what else could you do? When you had to figure out the total of how many people were on your train, what did you do? Have a look at the success criteria. I try to refer back to the learning intention and success criteria a number of times throughout the lesson, just so that students are aware of how they're going themselves. They can self-assess and say, well, I am using this strategy, so I'm doing it right. And it really, I find it really builds their confidence up to know that they are being successful in some way or another.